Hello, we're here today to talk about etiquette and manners and books we've written for children. And first I'd like to introduce my sister-in-law, Cindy Post-Senning.
Hi, and I'd like to introduce my sister-in-law, Peggy Post. Peggy, why don't you start and give us a clue as to why etiquette's important, why we think it's really a key thing for us to talk to kids.
Well, first of all, even with adults, so many people wonder, what is this big word etiquette all about? And it really is based on three simple and very important principles, and that's about being considerate and respectful and honest. And I always say honest with tact. And etiquette makes life run so much more smoothly if we apply those principles, and that's why etiquette is important.
One of the things that we talk about is that it's important to be teaching and learning about etiquette all through your growing up time. And what we've been able to do is identify some stages of social development. So there are times, as you get older, that you can learn to do different things. So there's a developmental stage that would encompass toddlers. And for example, your toddler isn't going to be able to step out from behind your leg and shake hands and look somebody right in the eye. But you could certainly expect your six-year-old to do that. What's the magic word? There isn't a child out there that we talk to who doesn't remember that please is one of the very first words they learned.
2 and 3-year-olds are absorbing everything that everyone around them is doing. And so they're watching their parents. And even little things like the parent using napkin, they realize that there's a reason. It's going to help make things neater.
One of the things that we've done with HarperCollins is we have created 10 different books that address kids at different ages as they move along that social spectrum. Emily's Christmas Gifts is about all those gifts that we don't have to wrap. What are the things we can give people during this busy season that really have a lot of meaning? Then is a book for tweens, you know, those middle school age kids, in between age kids, and it's on table manners. Oh my goodness, you get asked about table manners all the time. And I think if parents have one concern, it's how to get their kids to chew with their mouths closed. That's a classic one. All our lives, we sprinkle a variety of celebrations and important rites and traditions. Good example, who doesn't think about their prom at high school as sort of an important time in their lives? It is full of manners. It's a little bit like later when people get married, they go right to the etiquette books to figure out how to do it right. Well, believe it or not, that's the way teens feel about their proms. They want to know how to get it right.
Teens have so many questions, and some of the most enjoyable parts of what Cindy and I do is we get to work with kids, teens, younger kids, everybody in between, and we'll have workshops with kids. And the teens especially, it's so much fun. I love working with them. They'll come into the room and they'll just be not very happy about being there. And once they realize that manners and etiquette help them have confidence in knowing what to do, they start to listen.
Really be the kind of person you want your child to be. If you are respectful and considerate and honest, you're likely to have children who are respectful, considerate, and honest. And they begin absorbing that really even in infancy. You can't start too early creating that kind of a culture in your home life. If you do those two things, if you really are the kind of person you want your child to be, and you know what to expect and then you expect it, you're going to have kids who are courteous, polite, honest, just so kind, wonderful children. We know that.